Hello and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Enderal. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today I'll be reading Encyclopedia Arcana Magic Part 4, which I found right here in the mayor's house in Rivervale. Encyclopedia Arcana Magic Part 4, written by Balador Del Goldenstein. Cultural stance on magic. Even in a civilized world, the stance on magic varies greatly between countries. This is primarily due to two causes: the varying ideals of the gods themselves and the native cultures before the lands were conquered by the Lightborn. 1. Enderal. In Enderal, every mage has to report their talent to the Holy Order upon discovery and undergo the journey to the water. Refusing to do so renders one a wild mage in the eyes of the law, and therefore a pathless criminal. After completing the journey to the water, the mage's name will be added to a register and their status elevated to Arcanist. Skilled Arcanists, especially those who take on the novitiate and join the Holy Order, are highly regarded, although they often face distrust and fear as well. According to the 101 Holy Verses, magical talent is not in opposition to the holy path assigned to an individual. If, for example, a farmer discovers magical talent within himself, he is still expected to continue on the manufacturer's path upon completion of the journey to the water. Magical talent is thus to be understood as a challenge which must be conquered. 2. In other lands. In Nerim and Araziel, the approach to magic is very similar to the Enderalian way, at least in the civilized parts. Kyra and Calais have fewer regulations surrounding magic. There, the magically gifted can join so-called mage circles, consortia of arcanists offering their services as mercenaries and researchers. These circles represent very progress-oriented and pragmatic ideals, which is why many notable arcanists and researchers of Vin originate from them. Although a free-spirited individual may find these thoughts appealing, it is an open secret that certain circles, especially the Shintoza, also offer their services for more unscrupulous research purposes. For further information, the student of magic is recommended to read the work The Shintoza, Facts and Speculation, from the same author. Sigil of the Shintoza. The lands of the wild handle magic, as one would expect, in a primitive and almost pitiful manner. They attribute their magical talents to non-existent idols or the voices of the dead and practice shamanistic rituals. For this reason, they will not be elaborated on further in this tome. Librarian's Note: since the death of Eridan and the takeover of Nerim by Chancellor Baratheon, only the members of Baratheon's guard are permitted to use magic. Wild mages, especially Aeterna, are pursued and punished with draconian brutality. The root of this persecution is, presumably, the Chancellor's fear that his power might be challenged. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Enderal, Encyclopedia Arcana, Magic, Part 4.